the sole purpose of the African American Student Leadership and Educational Conference is to empower and inspire our African American youth to do better academically, socially, and to build their social emotional skills so that those things that otherwise would be a hindrance for them, they can turn it into a positive. Sure, it's just one day, but the ultimate goal is to have those students leave the conference, go back to their campuses, engage with their advisors, teachers, administrators on how to bring change to their campuses for the campus as a whole, but also as them as an individual, and to give them that confidence in their abilities to be amazing students and people in general. So we want to bring them only the best. That's in speakers, college recruiters, facilitators, you name it. We want that day to be about growing and being a difference, making a difference in their community.
Today, you are part of, and you do know this, I think, on some level, but let's just be explicit, you are part of something that is larger across the country. You are part of a movement that has been in the making for a long time, but it's a longing for and an active push for justice for African American youth. It is a longing for and an active push for the opportunity through education to achieve your dreams. Every young woman, young man, regardless of school, district, zip code, circumstances, that should be there. You are part of that push. Because we all know that a quality education fulfills the promise that our country still has for you. I'll be very clear, it is harder now than ever it was before. It is harder now, but here's the option. You don't have another option. So it's harder now, but you have to persevere. You have to build this network that will help you get through difficult and tough times. You have to find positive people who can help you further develop your leadership. You have to find a way to stay connected so that you get what you are actually out to get and achieve in this world. You have to, in short, create your own destiny. You have to develop your own destiny. Everything I've said so far has been rooted in verbs. You have to do something. Great things, your desires, your dreams, your wishes are not gonna come to you if you're sitting on the couch playing video games.
Students, today is for you. So our hope and prayer is that you take away from today something that will encourage you to go back to your prospective high school campuses and change the narrative. We hear a lot today about our schools, about your experiences. We know what's happening in our communities, but you must know that the change that you are demanding starts with you. So today is about changing the narrative on how society looks at you, how you feel about you, how your friends feel about you, and how you can affect your educational successes. Is that all right? Can you do that today? Now look, if I was Jay-Z or Drake or Beyonce, y'all be pooping and hollering and everything else. Is that all right with y'all today? Changing the narrative is about changing the way they feel about themselves, changing the way they think about how things are supposed to be. Society says African-American students just can't cut it. Society says most African-American males are gonna go to prison. Society says African-American females are gonna be pregnant with a bunch of kids on the system. That's the narrative that surrounds our community right now. And so when we came up with changing the narrative, because it's something that President Obama has used when he started his My Brother's Keeper initiative, and he talked about, we gotta change the narrative for our young men at that time. And then so on with our young ladies. And so for me, in sharing it here in Fresno, when we have dropout rates of over 30%, when we've got only 9 to 10% of our kids performing above standard academically, when you have all these depressing numbers, it's like, okay, you guys, I know you're smarter than this. I know you know how to do these things. It's time for us to change our own narrative, because society's not going to change it for you.
You know, I want every kid in this community to believe in themselves, and particularly our African American kids, who sometimes seem to get lost in this shuffle of adults, and they need to be out of that. They need to know that whatever they want to do in life, they can. And I mean, I'm a product of that, but I'm the reverse product. I mean, you know, the greatest mentor in my life was an African American male, Dr. Noel Smith, who, you know, put his arms around me and loved me and. But, you know, kick me, you know, square in the, you know, in the rear when I wasn't doing the right
Absolutely.
Thing.
That's
but
what these kids need, really.
These kids just, they need to know that they're important. They haven't figured that out yet. And that's, if there's anything they can take away from today, I just want them to know that we believe in them, we care about them, we love them, you know, and we want them to be our next generation of leaders, of course.
I could see myself in these young men. And the only difference is that I grew up in an environment that was a little bit more forgiving. So when I made a mistake, the consequences were not as severe. I had people who encouraged me, not just my mom and grandparents, but wonderful teachers and community leaders. And they'd push me to work hard and study hard and make the most of myself. And if I didn't listen, they said it again. And if I didn't listen, they said it a third time. And they would give me second chances and third chances. They never gave up on me. And so I didn't give up on myself. And I told these young men my story then, and I repeat it now, because I firmly believe that every child deserves the same chances that I had. And that's why we're here today, to do what we can in this year of action to give more young Americans the support they need to make good choices and to be resilient and to overcome obstacles and achieve their dreams.
So the African American Student Leadership Conference started back in 2008. My thorough understanding is that it was a vision of Mr. Cedric Hardeman, who we honored at the conference this year. And he came together with Dr. Carlo Prandini from Clovis Unified, and they started hosting the conference at Clovis Unified. And so from that point is when I became a part of the actual planning of the event. And so the whole goal was to empower and equip students with tools that were going to help them become better students, better people, want to go out and help their communities and things like that. So we were bringing in speakers and facilitators to meet with them in a more intimate environment in order for those students to ask questions and get that one-on-one and more intimate conversation about issues that were important to them.
Wake up all the teachers, time to teach a new way. Maybe then they'll listen to what you have to say. They're the ones who's coming up, and the world is in their hands. When you teach the children, teach them the very best you can. The world won't get no better if we just let it be. Na, 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 na. The world won't get no better. We gotta change it now. Just you and me.
when one conference is over, I automatically start thinking about, okay, what is next year going to be like? Because principal at Clovis North and I, when we were doing a lot of the planning, it was always about knocking it out of the park. And it's like, okay, how do we top this one, right? And so, you know, we, this year, Superintendent Hansen had a relationship with a gentleman, Brigadier General Terry Williams, who was our morning keynote speaker. And my understanding is Brigadier General was the highest ranking African American officer in the Marine Corps, and he was over recruiting on the East Coast. And his message was really about, you know, he faces enemies every day when he has to go out on the front line and he's training these young people, you know, to face the enemy. But I remember he had mentioned that, you know, in society, their enemy is their skin sometimes, or their enemy could be poverty, or it could be all these different things, and how they could turn those enemies into championship moments.
Whenever I take a false step or two, I feel the consequences. There are consequences to bad judgment, to making wrong conclusions. And we're given those options in life. And so quite frankly, the decisions we make must be good, and they must be educated decisions. And your judgment is important, because it's your judgment that helps you make those decisions correctly, smartly. So always remember, judgment.
We had some facilitators. We had Gerald Hankerson. And when I had heard his story, it blew me away, because here's this man who was wrongfully convicted of a crime and had to serve 20 years of his life. But in that, he continued to fight. He began, you know, he got his education and he started to see things, and he started figuring out ways that he could make things better, you know, and finally he gets out after 20 years, and instead of being angry at the system, he wanted to make things better for somebody else. And a lot of our kids are in situations where maybe their parents or their uncles or their brothers or whoever are in that situation, so they were able to hear a positive encouragement through that. We had Keena McFadden, who was working with our girls, and we know that our young ladies need all the empowerment they can get. And just for her to speak positive into them and give them something to take away, that's always important, because how one feels on the inside directly affects how they handle situations. We had Clayton Muhammad and his young men from Boys to Men out of Aurora, and that has just been a program that has been near and dear to my heart, because here are these young men of different ethnicities coming together to unite their community, to show that it doesn't matter what your skin color is, we can all come together, and I'm gonna help you, even though I'm white and you're black, I'm gonna help you and vice versa. So it's a message I think that our young men needed to hear and see, especially here in Fresno, because we're such a diverse community. We really need our young men to understand the importance of, yeah, it's okay to be you, and it's okay to have your partners, but you gotta remember you need other people too, you know, to come into that fold and help you find those successes. And then we always have Dr. Kahinde talking about our culture and our heritage, because if they don't know where they've come from, there's no way they're gonna understand that a lot of this is repetitious and that they can help stop that cycle. So, and then in the afternoon we have Mike Harris.
Heard my upbringing, what I came through, what happened for me, not to me. And I'm just hoping that you understand that where you are now is not where you'll be later. Thank you.
When you talk to these kids here in the Central Valley, do you hear something in these kids that kind of inspires you?
Wow, yeah. Well, they're way, way more advanced than I was at that age, because they know what they want to do, or they have an idea that someone can help them. And to come to a conference like this, to come listen to motivational speakers, to hear about job placement and things they can do, is leagues ahead of anything I did that age. But it was inspiring. They actually inspired me. I can't go back, but it's for our future, the young men and women that are coming up, especially in this area, I was pretty impressed.
When I go into that process of who am I going to bring, I'm looking at who's going to make the biggest impact. Who are the kids going to see is that's real? You know, it's not fake. It's not made up. It's not fluffed. It's just real. And so whenever I start that process, that's exactly what I'm thinking about, is who can make the biggest impact that those kids will be talking about it the next year. And I think that's the most important part.
Clark Atlanta serves a lot of California students. California is actually our second state outside of the state of Georgia. And so we just want to kind of continue growing that population and really focused on serving the black community. That's really been our legacy.
Hey, Norfolk State, we are located in Norfolk, Virginia, home to the largest naval base in the world. We are a Division I school. The requirements to get in, the GPA, we're looking for a 2.8 with a minimum of a 2.3. SAT, we're looking for 890 on math and verbal, which is minimum of 800, ACT of a 19, minimum of a 17. Our football stadium holds around 30,000 people. We just renovated our track and field, so we have a brand new track. The whole heart of our campus is giving brand new life. So we have a brand new student union building. That'd be a place to socialize. So you have Chick-fil-A, Tropical Smoothie, Pizza Hut. We just built a brand new $4.2 million nursing and general education building, as well as a brand new library. So the whole heart of our campus is basically brand new. A lot of changes taking place.
We're looking to bring back as many students as we can. We sell education at Texas College. We believe we have a great program. We have several different majors of excellence. We're in our bachelor's program, and we have two associate programs at our school. We're a small school with big school spirit and heart. So we have all your extracurricular activities. We have the Divine Nine. We have all of your sororities and fraternities.
Okay.
We have all your sports. We have a little of everything to offer. We're a very diverse institution.
Yeah.
We're in the heart of Texas, the Rose Capital, Tyler, Texas.
Okay.
And that's 100 miles east of the great Dallas-Fort Worth.
Okay.
And 90 miles west of the Shreveport, Louisiana state line.
Yeah,
so we fall right in the middle of Texas. East Texas. And so what we're looking to do is give those students who are looking to go to a traditional HBCU the opportunity to come west, come back east and go to school.
This was the first year that we actually had HBCUs, you know, to come in. And that is not cheap by any means. You know, these are schools that are working on very skeletal budgets. You know, to come out to California, that is such a feat for them. And so to be able to have 18 to 20 of them under the roof that day and offering on the spot admissions and scholarships to our young people, you know, can you imagine a kid coming in thinking, well, I'm probably going to City College and I'll be okay, and walk up to a counter with their transcript and that admissions recruiter says, you know what, I can give you a full ride, or I can give you admission right here today if you want to come. It's like, where does that happen, right? But it takes money to do that. We're gracious. I mean, like I said, Jim Uvino and Fresno County Office of Ed, they took care of the facility, which was a huge expense. But support is something that we really, truly need for this event. It's something that would be really nice to have paid for by community sponsors that say, we believe in these kids, we believe in the message, we believe in what's happening here, and to, you know, come full circle with it. We had Councilmember Oliver Baines, I mean, the councilman's budget, you know, it's not a whole lot, but $1,000 goes a long way, you know, at 30 bucks a kid. We were grateful to Pardini's, who's the premier caterer at the event. They brought down their expense just a little bit for us as a sponsorship. Alpha Custom Graphics did our lanyards and our t-shirts, and they, you know, everybody did a little piece of it, and all those dollars add up. We are asking for our community to come full circle with us, because we have a group of kids that are amazing kids and want to do some amazing things with their lives, just need a little bit of support. And so we definitely are grateful to every sponsor, individual that said, we want to help you. I mean, the Lynx, they take on the Senior of Distinction Award for us every year, where we honor a male and a female student from every high school that have done those things, that have put their nose to the grind and got it done, or came through a hardship, you know, and they're being honored for that. It's accolades. It's about saying, telling those juniors and sophomores and freshmen that are coming up, look what I went through. You can do it, and we can do it together. So, I mean, whether it's small amounts or big amounts, it helps, you know, to just another experience, another positiveness to these kids to say, your community loves you enough to do this for you. We are the children.
This is extremely important. It's just a great thing for us African Americans here in Fresno to be able to come together and just learn about our history and to learn about where we come from and our origins. And then I think it's also a great experience for everybody just to be able to learn about where we from and how we excelled in time.
Each student being on separate campuses, they're again in those bubbles where they think it's just them. We take them out of those bubbles and we put them with all these other people and these other kids that look like them, where they otherwise wouldn't have that experience where they are. I mean, Fresno is what it is. Most of our campuses are 2-4% black. So, you know, but when they leave and go to college, they are now able to understand the importance of having conversations. Most of them probably would have went to college and not wanted to be involved in any kind of group on that college campus. But because of a BSU group or because they were a part of this conference, they were able to, a couple of them were like, it was a lot easier to go sit in, you know, on a lecture series. It was a little bit easier to, you know, when somebody saw something or they witnessed something, they were able to relate to it a little bit better. When they would hear of a special speaker coming in, they were more apt to want to go listen, because they've had these experiences. And then they were a little bit more comfortable asking questions of those people about their issues and how it related to them. So I think we're giving them a really good experience because the speakers that we bring in, they're okay with the students asking them questions and them giving them that answer. And so I think it just really opened up their mindset more so to, even though it's not just us in the room, it's okay to ask that question, and it's okay to engage that process because it's only gonna make you better. And so when you see a kid walking around with that t-shirt on and it says, I am changing the narrative, they have committed to making a positive change. And that's really what this conference is all about.
I am a mountain, I am a tall tree. Oh, I am a swift wind sweeping the country. I am a river down in the valley. Oh, I am a vision, and I can see clearly. If anybody asks you who I am, just stand up tall, look them in the face and say, I'm that star up in the sky. I'm that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it. I'm the world's greatest. And I'm that little bit of hope. When my back's against the ropes, I can feel it. I'm the world's greatest. The world's greatest. The world's greatest. Forever. I am a giant. I am an eagle.